The purpose of this video is to show you how to build a MVC framework, to learn how clean URL, controller, layout, and view are working together. I assume you have some understanding about model view controller paradigm. I will use the default Ubuntu web document root directory. It is located at var/www.html. We are going to create some directories and files here. Let us monitor this directory. Creating some directory here. Model is for interacting with the database tables. We won't touch the model part in this video. We may make a separate video for the model in the future. All the controller files will be inside the controller directory. Let us start creating some controllers. Before that, let me tell what is the demo application we will build along with creating the MVC framework. It's a simple coding tutorial website which will contain two subjects, algorithm and mathematics. Let us create a mathematics controller. Class name is math. We are going to create a page for multiplication table. We will give the name as a table. We need to set a title for this page. Times table. The views corresponding to this page need some parameters. So we will set a member variable params. Rows of the multiplication table, columns of the multiplication table. Here there is no view template file mentioned. Our framework has a convention that template file will have the same name as the page name. Let us create a controller for algorithm. Inside this controller, there will be two pages. I have already written this controller. Let us have a look at it. Here there are two pages defined, sort and big O. Sort passes a list as a parameter and Big O passes a dictionary as parameter. There should be a view directory for each controller. Let us create view directories for our two controllers. Let us create the view for the math table page. Views for algorithm page. I have already written these views. Let's have a look at it. It is a page for big O. There we are passing a dictionary. We are taking the key as a notation and value as a name, and we are printing. Let us look to next page. This is a sort page where we are passing a list of sort names, and it is just printing that one as unordered list. This is a multiplication table where we have two loops. One is for rows and another for columns. We are just printing the multiplication of row into column here. We have discussed page views so far. Let us create the view for the main layout. There can be many layouts, one for guest users, another for logged in users. So let us create a directory for layout. But right now we have only one layout view. Let us start the work of index.php also. It is the entry point to our framework. Opening the math page through a command line browser to monitor our framework progress. Added a query parameter for testing purpose. Look like we don't have a permission to the web root directory. Let us give the permission. Let us go to Apache configuration file. Here we need to add a directory directive. Let us give permission. Let us restart the Apache server. Shows file not found. The reason is that Apache is looking in a directory named math under the web root. Let us tell to Apache all requests should go to index.php. Let us write the HTTP access for Apache configurations. Turn on the rewrite engine. Write the rewrite rule for all requests should go to index.php. Here one problem is there. We may have some static resources like JS, CSS, and all. So we don't want to all those requests go to index.php. There is an option in rewrite engine. You can mention the rewrite condition also for the rewrite rule. In our framework, we have only one static resource, style.css. We will add a rewrite condition. Requests for style.css should not go to this rewrite rule. there is no change in the error message. Look like Apache is not reading .ht access file. Let us verify it. Just make one invalid directory. The error message is still there. That means that maybe it is not reading the .ht access file. There is a directive allow override to enable .ht access. Let us add that one. Let us restart the Apache. Showing internal server. It may be because the invalid directory we added in .ht access. Let us remove that one. It is still showing the internal server error. Let us look into error log. Showing invalid command rewrite engine. Corresponding module mode rewrite may not be enabled. Let us enable that one. We need to restart Apache. We are not getting any error message. Let us continue working on index.php. Let us include the layout. Layout file needed two variables. View. And title. Including layout. I have added style.css here. Let me add a basic layout structure. So here you can see that one. We have three columns. Top column for website banner, left column for menu, and the right column for the page. Let me change the banner text. Okay, now let me change this right column. We know that when we are passing two variables, title and view. Let me add that. First, adding title. Next, I will add a view. You can see that one page title is coming there. Now page view also coming. Now let us modify the left column. We will add a menu here. The menu will contain two subjects, algorithm and mathematics. Each subject will have topics under that menu. Okay, added. So you can see that one algorithm is a subject and a sort and big are topics under that subject. Math is another subject and a table is a topic under that subject. Those are all links. You can see here href is added. Here we want controller name and page name. Those information are in URL. Let us read that URL. There is a predefined variable underscore server in PHP which will contain server and execution environment information. Let us look into that array. Here you can see that one. Here you can see request URI which contain the URI and query string. Another key is redirect URL which contain only URI. Let us read that one. Redirect URL. Yeah, we got this one. Now we want to extract controller name and page name. Let us use explode. Splitting by forward slash. You can see that one, we got three parts. First part is empty string, second part is controller, third part is page name. Let us assign this variable to this part to some variable. First we will add some dummy variable. Second is controller name. Third is page name. Yep. Let me remove this printer. Okay. Now let me include the controller. Here I hard coded math controller name. We need to replace with the variable. Next we included the controller class. Let us create object for that class. Here we need to give a controller name. Now let us call the page function. Here we know that one page name is in variable. Let us use that variable. Okay, so we got both controller and invoked page function. Now let us include the view. Now you can see that one we included this view, but it says that one undefined variable rows. We know that we added a params in controller. That parameter should be passed to this view page. Let me do that. For each. The parameters in params parameter name, parameter value. Now we will define a variable dynamically with the variable dollar name. Yeah, now you can see that one that parameters error is disappeared, but one problem here is view is coming first and layout is coming down. So what we want is that whenever we are including the include, it will automatically send the output to HTTP response. So we want to capture that include page part and assign to a variable. There is a output buffering in PHP. Let us turn on that. Then that results will go to output buffer instead of the HTTP response. It is starting with the output buffering, starting with the OB start. Next, we need to stop the buffering and read the buffer to view variable. Let us do that. Okay, we forgot to add a semicolon here. Okay, now you can see that one. View came and we need to change the title. We know that one's title is in a controller title. Yeah, now let me remove this we got the title, we got the menu and the page title and the page view. Yeah, this is all for this video. Bye.